Round 2 action unfolding in the water. Wiggly Dontas and Michelle Perez about to fight it out here for a spot in Round 3. A big heat for Wiggly, pressing for a spot in the top 10. He can do that with a huge result. Michelle Perez, he's trying to fight his way back into a position as we see Michelle now taking the first wave of Heat 8. Drives off the bottom, plenty of power, well-timed hit, great adjustment, and manages a float on a tricky section of riding late to the lip, but great control, and Wiggly behind him, stalling for the barrel now. Not a really deep tube, but climbs up and gets a little finish as well. 21 and a half minutes to go. There's your opening exchange, waiting for scores to drop.
Big points with ease. You know, get a tube ride. Watch how trippy this section is right here. He got there pretty late, but it panned out for him. It was really bizarre how it allowed him to hit it. Even that second maneuver, again, he arrived up to the lip late, but he kind of pulled it off. But as you can see right there, didn't really ride out of it clean. Not the best barrel, but nonetheless, a little tube time for Wiggly. And then another late maneuver, but he rode out of it. So,
and scores starting to come through now from the open exchange as Wiggly finds a big set wave, and it holds open. And he punches through the back of that one. He had a 2.93 on his first wave. Michelle Perez, he got a slightly better score, just a three-point ride.
He was ripping pipe. Maybe he was 21, 22 years old, so he has a knack for this kind of tube riding right here. He's been comfortable for a long time in big hollow waves. In fact, keep your eyes peeled when we get to pipeline. Wiggly will be...
wants to make the last heat in 2015. Wants to get his first win. Just over 17 minutes remaining, scores coming through in the past. But it actually boiled over once they got back to the competitors area. Came to blows, in fact. As we see Michelle now just pulling through the back of this one. But that was massive news in the surfing world when that unfolded.
I was there for that. I remember looking down on Andy Irons. He was showering after the heat. He was really boiled over. He was mad. It's not super deep. They really, you know, they're not happy. You can see right there, you know, that was pretty good barrel. I mean, if I'm in a booth judging, I'm throwing that about a 6.55, somewhere in there. You know, I know they want to see you pretty deep, but that's not exactly easy for him to position himself deep enough to get that barrel. And it's not as if he dodged anything. He wasn't trying to get out of the way of any harm. He showed some commitment. Beautiful wave, well overhead. But again, the judges keeping it really low just because they didn't like the fact that he wasn't really deep. But I'm calling this pretty harsh.
In a coaching capacity, as we see live action now and pulling into the barrel, Michelle Perez gets some cover. Drives out onto the open face. Little backhand carve now. A bit more of a vertical approach to finish. Doesn't ride out of that last turn, which is a shame. A major maneuver there to finish that ride off. Just under 10 minutes to go, Ross.
On those right-handers, or the second heat of the day, and he found those rights over there. And now it seems to be all the focus on the left-handers. So pretty decent barrel there for Michelle. I like this turn. Bingo. But that backwash kind of really made that wave breathe up. And it's really tough to come out of that. That angle makes that barrel look a little better. A little claim from Michelle. But you can see there's a big old right-hander coming at him right here. So it's always going to be tough to ride out of that thing.
We'll expect a decent number. Michelle Perez, he nabs himself a 4.67. The scale quite low for this heat. In an event he won last year with a quarter final. And here he is at the Quicksilver Pro France, taking off on a wave that's going to run away from him. But Michelle's year really fell apart when, after Margaret River, he was at home, tapped into a big swell at Chopu. 3.5 minutes remaining. Priority sits with the Brazilian. Wiggly looking for a 4.21. Michelle Perez, though, without priority, keeping busy on the inside. You don't often see surfers punch through the curtain here. And he's going to have a swing using priority. He grabs the rail. Stylish entry. And he is deep in the pit. And the wave spits. Can Wiggly find his way through? What went wrong inside that barrel? It looked like he had done everything right from the outset. The takeoff was great.
Let's see what happened here. This is sort of from the front on. There he adjusted right away. He knew he was pretty deep. You saw him shuffle his feet forward. And right there, just a touch of backwash too. It made that wave breathe inside the barrel. Once that lip touches you in the shoulder, this is the angle I wanted to see. Right here, he shifts his weight forward. He's trying to get all that momentum down towards the channel. But that wave had a weird wonk on it, didn't it, Ronnie? So as that barrel kind of shifted up and down, for sure he touched the barrel. And once you touch the lip line inside a barrel like this, and we just talked about it, at beach break, that's so powerful, it just pushes you down.
Well, lost opportunity there for Wiggly Dantes. He puts a 1.93 on the board. It doesn't go into his top two, so the requirement. And here is Wiggly now, just taking off, hoping for this wave to do something, at least offer a few sections that he can tap into. He's after a 4.21. And I don't think it's going to matter what he does on this wave. You've got to think back to his 3.47, which was amazing. He surfed that wave very well, but again, he had a left that was probably an 8-foot wave. Wiggly's last ride comes through at it. It's a 2.5. Not enough. He needed a 4.21. And the Tahitian is going to be moving on to round three with a 4.67 and a 3. Not a massive heat score total, but he's done enough to stay alive in the draw here at the Quicksilver Pro. More action to come in just a moment. Joel Parkinson and Keanu Singh hitting the lineup.